this your first trip to Lambeau Field?
Yes, it is my first trip. First, like, real cold game.
Yeah. Are you aware of, I guess, the history, the lore, the whole, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. My dad's reminded me about it all week long. You know, he's super excited to get out there. He bought some flights to go out there and watch me. He's excited for that environment. But, yeah, I've heard all about it. Excited to go to that legendary stadium.
What's kind of the mood right now? A lot of football to be played, but there's a certain sense of urgency on this team has to be right now.
Yeah, for sure. You know, we're really hungry right now, you know, in the position that we are at. We're looking at every game as a must win, so we're excited to go out there and put it on tape.
Can you put any kind of key to what the issues are right now? You know, it feels like you guys are playing from behind the chains a lot of the time and obviously not having the red zone success that you'd like to have.
For sure. I think it just comes down to execution, you know, and that just starts in practice. You know, reviewing all of our stuff, making sure we're perfect on all of our details, and then just eliminating stuff that is going to shoot ourselves in the foot, penalties and stuff like that are going to put us behind the chains.
From what we saw, Brock didn't throw it at practice yesterday. Has this been like kind of an acclimatization week working with Brandon Allen for you at practice?
Yeah, man. I mean, I'm just go out there and do my own job, you know what I mean? Do what I can to get open and make it really clear for him. So, you know, I'm just going to do what I normally do, get open, create separation, and go make plays for him.
Are you feeling more and more just kind of comfortable and confident in this offense? Obviously, you haven't been at it that long yet.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I'm still trying to learn all the, like, the fine details of the system, but I feel like I'm way more comfortable with it now, and I pretty much got it down for the most part. There's just little things that I got to still clean up, but, you know, that's just going to come with time and putting in the effort and practice.
Well, there's a lot of football still to be played, but there has to be a certain sense of urgency on this team right now. You guys can't really afford too many lapses, can you?
Yeah, absolutely. I think there's a big sense of urgency.
Tell me about your experiences with Lambeau and Green Bay and the cold and all that kind of thing.
Man, it's one of the coolest places to play, I think. Just the history of that stadium, you know, all the names on the Ring of Honor. You know, and I think we're going to get some pretty good weather, too, which would be nice. But played one game there, Blizzard. A long time ago. That's my only experience, though, but it'll be a good atmosphere.
It's not a mystery what you guys need to do, you know, the red zone scoring, all those various things. Is there anything you can point to as things that you can correct, or is it too easy to just say that, you know, and that you have to correct those kinds of things?
Yeah, I think it's a combination of a lot of things, but it's just one play at a time executing.
Question for you, two games back, how are you feeling physically, and how are you where you want to be in your performance thus far?
I don't know if I'll ever be where I want to be, but no, definitely physically getting better and, you know, starting to develop that callousness.
Obviously, Brock hadn't practiced, I guess, in 2 days. You must notice that out there. What is it? What's the sense when your starting quarterback is not practicing?
You know, for me, I've never worried about, you know, who's in, especially on Thursday in practice. You know, I've seen enough guys not practice all week and go out and have incredible games. So you just, you know, he'll handle his business, we'll all handle ours, but just try to focus on me, you know, one play at a time and being where I'm supposed to be.
If it is Brandon Allen on Sunday, is there a similarity between the two quarterbacks? Would the, you know, the offense necessarily be a lot different with a different passer?
You know, I don't know. I don't care who's back there for me. I got to be in a spot. I got to be there fast and, you know, just prepared for anything. But I just control what I can control.
You mentioned the one run where you said you could have ended the game. Was it just a read that you were disappointed in? Was it a...
I got a half.
Okay. I like that.
Yeah.
We're about the same height now.
Trying to whack you with that thing?
Sorry, man. It's a weapon.
All right, Jerry, when you put the tape in on Love, what jumps out?
His ability to make throws from all different angles, you know, off the back foot, running sideways, rolling out to his opposite side, you know. He makes a lot of great throws, man, and the angles he throw the ball is pretty good.
I know head coach Kyle Shanahan said he doesn't really call any game a must-win unless it's a must-win. There was a similar situation against the Seahawks earlier in the season. Does it kind of feel kind of like that going into this one?
Me personally, I feel like every game is a must win. Like, I, you ask me, you know, I want to win them all. You know what I mean? So I don't take no game lightly. I treat every game with the same approach. You know, so for me, yes, it's a must win.
Urgency with every game for you?
Urgency for every game. It really don't matter. I mean, there's no safer way to play. You know, you go out there in a different mindset, you know, that things going to go the wrong way. Things are going to go the wrong way. You know, I'm expecting to dominate every game, you know. And I don't think all games should be close neither.
Yeah. I suppose it's the nature of this league that this late in the season, you're going to be dinged up. There's no team that isn't at this point. What do you guys have to do when you have new personnel and, you know, a situation like last week where you need one stop to win the game and you have different personnel? What kind of adjustments do you have to make when they aren't guys that you're used to seeing on every down?
It's not really no adjustments, man. You know, we just got to – it don't matter who out there, man. Everybody got to come together as a team. And if somebody goes down, like a Bosa goes down, whoever next up, you know, got to replace Bosa and be the same way that he was on the field. You know, that's easier said than done. But it's next man up mentality. We're not going to make no excuses on who's out there and who's not.
Yeah. And they run an offense that's really similar to the one you ran because of Kyle and LaFleur knowing each other.
Right.
And you played them a couple of times in the last couple of years. Is there almost a danger of outthinking yourself, thinking, oh, I know what they're going to be doing next? And so it's just playing your own game?
Yeah, no, it's just playing your own game, man. Yeah. We all have keys that we read, you know, before the snap and post-snap. Mm-hmm. Follow your keys, you know, and then it'll take you to the play. Yeah, that's pretty much it. There's no guessing.
Love was saying this week that he started out with a knee injury, then he had a groin injury. Now he's actually moving around better than he has all year. Can you see that on film, that he's getting escaping and doing things down the field?
Nah, I haven't seen that on film. I've seen him escaping and doing things on field, but as far as the injuries and all that, I haven't seen none of that. It don't matter, you know. Whoever step out there, if healthy or not healthy, all that's out the window when you step on the field. You know, there's no excuses. When you out there, you out there.
Are you seeing kind of an evolution on his part of getting used to this league? It takes a little while to get used to this league, especially as a quarterback. Are you seeing him kind of develop as more of a veteran guy than what he initially was when you first looked at him?
Love?
Yeah.
Nah, he's definitely turned it over. Been good. Been had talent. You know, been had a talented arm. Just getting more comfortable in their scheme. You know, being able to put the ball in tight windows. And his confidence is going up more and more. So that's all it's about. Yeah.
What are your memories of the playoff game in Green Bay?
Oh, we won and it was cold.
Yes, yeah. And
oh, I remember Huff touchdown too. There I was on the sideline. I was freezing. I was happy for him though. You know, I was happy for Huff. I felt like that was Huff like coming out party, right, like with that touchdown.
Right. And you weren't playing that much. Were you very cold? Because you
Me and AT Ambry, we was watching Dante Johnson and Josh Norman.
Right.
They was getting after it, doing their thing.
Dima, what stands out about their receivers? They got three pretty good ones.
They're a good group, a good talented group, very young. You know, I would say they got some dog to them. You know, I like 11, 87. I grew up with 87, Romeo, and then 13. No, I like them. They got a good group. And I feel like they remind me some of Seattle, like last week. So it's going to be a 12-round fight.
Do you have a good rivalry with him?
Oh, yeah. We didn't play at each other every level except Pop Warner. We was on the same team. So kind of familiar with him.
Does that make it easier?
I wouldn't say it make it easier. It's going to always be a challenge because it's the NFL. You know, any given Sunday, you know, somebody can get you. So I'll just approach every game like I'm playing the best.
You've been with them at every level, and now you're at the highest level. Whether it's a text or whether you guys are just talking, it's like, how cool is this? And we made it all the way to the top.
Oh, yeah, it's always, you know, we always want to see each other do good and, you know, be the focal point of where we come from. Much luck to him. You know, I wish him the best. You know, he know when we between that lines, you know what time it is. And after the game, you know, we brothers.
When you're watching the film,
it's been a big help. You know, just to have that knowledge, you know, that experience, and you know, a guy that done been on every level, playing with in Super Bowls, NFC Championship, just to have that knowledge, you know, back in the room for all the other guys also that haven't played a lot of football.
Dima, as you're watching the film of the Packers, is there anything different than how they were in the wild card or in the division round game?
I would say they got more confidence, the receivers, because you know, like last year, I think like a lot of them were, well, two of them were rookies, I think, two of the three. So I'll just say they got a lot of more confidence, you know, more experience in with playing the game.
Jordan Love's thrown a pick in every game this season he's played. So as a quarterback, yeah, right?
Ooh.
You see opportunities on tape?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the stats is the stats. You know, he's a great quarterback, though. You know, he's been killing it this year. You know, much respect to him.
Dima, you always seem like you're fighting the guy on the other side, but this week against JSN, you get these guys blocking it up an awful lot.
I don't know with him, but it ain't no bad blood with me. You know, I just play the game of football. I just love it. So if you think I'm fighting out there, I'm not. I'm congratulating him.
This isn't technically a must win, but it's a, you know, probably a good idea to win. Does it feel like your backs are a little bit against the wall here?
Pressure make diamonds with us. So back against the wall, you know, we're going to fight back.
But it seems like you have a positive attitude about it. Like it's glass half full, not empty.
You said, I'm sorry.
You have a positive attitude about it. Like it's glass half full.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I'm always positive. I believe in this team. You know, I know we got in this locker room, you know, the type of character, the type of guys we got around here. So I'm not worried.